Now let us take these examples. A question is find the candidate keys in these relations. These are the question. Number one is we have the relation R A B C D E. The functional dependencies which are given, they are AB can determine C, C can determine D, and B can determine E. Second question is the relation is R A B C D E, and the functional dependencies are AB can determine C, C can determine D, B can determine EH or EA. Okay, so next question is like this. Assuming that the relation is R A B C D, functional dependencies are AB can determine CD and A can determine B. Fourth question is the relation is let me find a better question. So R A B C D and E, the functional dependencies are A can determine B, B C can determine D, and D can determine AE. Next question is the relation is like this. R A B C D E, functional dependencies are AB can determine C, CD can determine E, and DE can determine B. These are the options which are given. Okay, now let us take the first option. Let us find what is the candidate key which we can get from this relation. So it is R A B C D E. That means there are five attributes and these are the functional dependencies which are given. So what is the shortcut? Check the right hand side of every production, or you can check the right hand side of every functional dependency and see what are the attributes which are not present. So you can clearly see C is present, D is present, and E is present. AB is not present. So let us take the AB closure. So if AB closure cannot identify everything, then we have to add other attributes with AB. But if AB closure can identify everything, so obviously AB is a minimal candidate key, or you can say it is a minimal key. In the cases when AB cannot determine everything, then only we take other attributes. Okay, so AB closure will take AB can determine AB itself, that is trivial. AB can determine C, C can determine D, and you can see B can determine E. So you can identify everything. Therefore, AB is the key for this relation, and this is the only key here. We don't have more than one keys for this relation. Now let us check the next option. ABCD is there, and let us see what is not present at the right hand side. We have C, D, E, and A. C, D, E, and A, they are present. So only thing which is left is B. So let us take B closure. With the help of B, I can identify B. With the help of B, I can identify EA. Now with the help of AB, I can identify C, and with the help of C, I can identify D. Therefore, B is the candidate key, or you can say B is the key for this relation. It is also a key. It is also a super key. Okay, we cannot have more than one keys in this relation, because if I try to add one other attribute to B, then B will become a super key. It will not be a candidate key, or you can say it will not be a key. Right. So whenever I'm going to say key, that means I mean we have candidate key. Okay. Next is relation R A B C D. Now in this relation, let us identify what is not present in the right hand side. It is C is present, D is present, and B is present. Only thing which is not present is A. So if I take A closure, then I will be able to identify A. With the help of A, I'll be able to identify B, and with the help of A B, I will be able to identify C D. Therefore, A is a candidate key, or you can say it is a super key in the same way. Okay. Right. Because every candidate key is a super key. Now next relation B C D, in the right hand side we have B, we have D, we have A, we have E. Only thing which is not present is C. Now you can see if I take C closure, then I will only be able to identify C. I will not be able to identify anything other than C. So C cannot be a candidate key, as well as C cannot be a super key. So here in this case, we have to add other attributes to C so that we can see if we can get a candidate key or not. Now the first attribute here is A. So let us see if we find AC closure. Now with the help of AC closure, I can identify AC. With the help of A, I can identify B. With the help of BC, I will be able to identify D. And with the help of D, I will be able to identify AE. That means E. So AC is a candidate key. Okay, there can be more than one candidate key for this relation. Let us try to identify. If I add B with C, so BC closure. With the help of B, I can identify B and C itself. With the help of BC, I will be able to identify D. With the help of D, I will be able to identify A. So I will be able to identify everything. So BC is also candidate key. Now let us add D to this C. So DC closure. With the help of D, I can identify D and C. With the help of D, I can identify AE. And after AE, with the help of AC, we do not have, or with the help of A, I can identify B. Therefore, this is also a candidate key. Next is E. So if I take EC, if I take EC closure, then I will be able to identify EC. With the help of, with EC, will I be able to identify anything else? With the help of E, C, I will not be able to identify anything else because E can identify itself, C can identify itself, but it will not be able to identify anything else. So EC cannot be a key, right? So here in EC, we have to add other attributes to make it a key. But if we add an attribute AEC, now it will not be a candidate key or it will not be a key. Why? Because only with the help of AC, I can identify everything, right? If I add B, so BEC, still it will not be a key. If I add C, if I add D, so DEC will not be a key. In the same way, if I add other attribute, it will not be a key. So here in this case, you can clearly see, why these cannot be a key, because they are not minimal. Okay, because with a smaller set of them, I can identify everything. So here we have three candidate keys which are possible. So here you can clearly see that all these candidate keys are super key. Or if I take a superset of these keys, for example, if I take a superset of these like A, C, B or A, B, C, that will be able to identify everything. So these all are super keys. There are other super keys which are possible, but there are three candidate keys. So candidate key is a subset which is having three keys. Out of these three keys, I can take any key and I can make it as a primary key. Okay, that you already know what is a primary key. We'll see that in the later examples. Okay, now let us look at the last question. In the last question, they are saying we have AB determines C, CD determines E, and DE determines B. So we have E, C, E, and B on the right hand side. C, E, and B. A and D is not there. Therefore, if I take AD closure, let us see what are the things which we can identify. With the help of A, I can identify A only. With the help of D, I can identify D only. We'll not be able to identify everything. Therefore, AD is not a candidate key, so we have to add other attributes with AD to make it a key. So let me rub this up, and coming back to this. Okay, so we were discussing about the question number 5. Okay, we already discussed this question, so we are discussing about the question number 5. So I told you that in the right hand side we have C, E, and B. C, E, and B. AD is not there, so if we take AD closure, then AD closure can only identify AD, it cannot identify everything. So we have to add some other attributes. So other attributes are B, C, and E. If I take ABD closure, then ABD closure with the help of AB, ABD closure can identify itself. With the help of AB, I can identify C. With the help of CD, I can identify E. Therefore, it can identify everything else. Therefore, it is a candidate key. Let us add other attribute, which is C. If I take ACD closure, with the help of CD, I can identify E. With the help of A, it is trivial. And with the help of DE, I can identify B. So it is also a candidate key. If I take the third one, which is AED closure, with the help of AED, I can identify AED. With the help of DE, I can identify B. With the help of AB, I can identify C. Therefore, it is also a candidate key. Therefore, there are three candidate keys which are possible in this relation. Okay. Again, the set of candidate keys is a smaller set as compared to the set of super keys. Okay, so see, you can take a lot of questions like this. I have already taken 5 examples here. There are so many examples which are possible. Okay, so we'll do the previous year questions, then you can take the examples. But I think this much is enough to understand how many keys or how many candidate keys are possible. Okay.